Matt, it's going to be interesting seeing roles that don't have a bunch of disadvantages tied to them. Yeah, yeah, make a perception.
Couldn't be me.
Sure.
Oh, fuck.
Before I roll this, could I make a request?
Sure.
We're leveling up when we get all together. When we get to 9th level, I add my full dex mod to persuasion checks, or charisma checks, instead of half. Would you allow me to add the remaining 3 to this?
Sure. I think that's a good transition from
your
8 to 9.
Proficiency also goes up, so you get another plus 1.
Not that one, though.
No.
I will shut up.
Okay, so 24.
Jesus. 24.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. She stares at you and tilts her head, and she never blinks during it. It's rather uncomfortable and a little bit alien. I see, sir. Well, sir, because you're not, she knows, the fact that she calls you sir, not lord, means she knows your house's tradition of not making the firstborn lord. So she called you sir. That's an important note that you would catch and probably no one else in the fucking room. Unless they're noble adjacent, I guess. Anyways. I see. Well, welcome, Sir Risewell, to Sindel's Keep. Its sole hold. I'm surprised you weren't made aware of the situation, but as I said, it was a confidential matter, so I also understand why you weren't. She takes a step to the side and holds up her hand, one hand behind her back, one hand up in the air, gesturing at the banners, the numerous dozens of banners up there. These banners were given to his lordship here at this keep for a service rendered to the realm, for all the provinces. Every noble house has given their banner here. At the time, at least. But only a few new noble houses have been formed since His Majesty's return.
His Majesty's?
Correct. King Severin, the one at current, was killed. But then he came back.
Oh.
He got brought back. So.
He got better.
He got better. Yeah, I mean, you can ask the campaign one people because they're the ones that helped with it.
The ones that killed him.
Yeah. No, he got assassinated before the events of campaign one. His soul and body were held in a sort of temporal stasis by Exalted Lord Octavian. Mm-hmm. Wherein the forces of the void, as well as the forces of the divine, were basically duking it out in a control point manner for his soul. Until one side had the, scales tipped. You can thank an Infernal Legion for that one. So yeah. What? It's a known thing, not all that detail I just gave you, but it's a known thing that he did die, quote unquote die, and he did come back. Because that's how fucking great our king is, let's go baby! It definitely, for every assassin for the rest of history, it's gonna be like, are you sure you could kill the king? Someone did it before and it didn't take. Right? That's gonna be a precedent across eternity now, of like, are you sure? Are you sure?
They did kill the king, and it wasn't enough. Are you sure?
His soul didn't make it to the other side, is all I'm saying. So yeah, so that is a known event, that he did get killed but got brought back, and in his return, backed by Exalted Lord Octavian, order was restored across the provinces. What almost was a civil war breaking out was squelched. Mm-hmm. So when she says the return, you know what it means. Most provincials, you guys would know what it means.
Kasai's like, what the fuck are they on about?
Yeah, Kasai's like, I don't fucking know what you're talking about, dude. Look at all this is die all the time.
Man, imagine making such a big deal about your kingdom.
Right, so House Risewell's...
House Risewell was among... Yeah, like it was just sort of a sweeping thing every noble did. That's not even saying that the nobles know what the event was or the deed or whatever. They just did it because they knew a great things had to be given.
Alessandro nods and he says, right. you know, situation like that, I can imagine the Silver Swan and House Roswell as a whole was... Well, they did their part. Don't know how it didn't come to me.
It was a rather confidential matter, sir.
Right. Something that only the Lords of House Roswell would know. Gives her a nod, which, you know, given how alien she is, Steve realizes how pointless that was.
She nods back with like a smile on her face, like, I see you.
Mm-hmm. Right. Well, thank you for enlightening me.
Of course.
At all of them, apparently.
If they're in your company, sir, I imagine that you trust them with that information.
Most of them.
Which ones do you not?
which ones do you not?
Let me say it. No, she says that, and her expression immediately drops to a straight face. And it's not like a cheeky little thing. No, she's outright asking you.
I'm going to murder someone.
As you say, like, it's a joke. She smiles again. Oh, I see. My apologies.
They're gonna fucking murk a
Delvin, like, looks at, like, I don't know who'd be closest to America. He's just like, what the fuck was that? And she just pats him on the shoulder like, don't bring it up or it's gonna make it worse.
Oh, right, America. I've hardly said two words to her. I don't trust her too much.
Ariana does the same thing, but with Anushka just kind of looks over like, what the fuck just happened here?
Unquestioned.
Oh, wait. Hold on. You want to know what she looked like? She looked like.
I need to know. What did she look like?
Oh, I know exactly. Yep, there it is.
Perfect.
Who do you not trust? They will die.
Yeah. Anything else?
No. That was all the questions he had.
Roger. If no further questions remain for Maid Joanna, she guides you guys back through the same corridor, same long... okay, the descent down all those stairs, way easier than going up them, just saying.
Mm-hmm.
Going down all the stairs into the teleport room and da-da-da-da-da, and then she gets it all set up and coordinated.
After going up these stairs, do we get the plus one to athletics as well, or...?
Do we want to roll athletics to see who does the worst climbing the stairs?
Oh my god,
we're going down the stairs. Like, how hard gonna be?
Who trips and falls down all the flights of stairs?
If you guys want to, be my fucking guest.
Oh god! Oh no!
Alexander, I'm sorry to say.
No, I can't roll the worst. I'm perfect.
You're gonna do two characters with Beth, Alex.
It's because Kasai takes her breath away.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So it's really cold in here. You slip on like an air and some gray ice. That's part on top of the stairway. You slip.
Mm-hmm. It's actually the whole thing.
You slip and you fall into Anushka and Oriana. You have to like sort of catch you
mm-hmm. to make sure the rest of everyone doesn't fall down.
Yeah. Yeah. You know, normal stuff.
Be careful. It's quite slippery here.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Thanks for taking the chance.
Are you sure? Are you sure?
No. Let him have any semblance of his dignity. Thanks for taking the lead, Alexander.
Yeah, that's fucked up.
Just shove him back up there.
Shove me. Shove your captain.
Shove him down.
Hey, we're off mission right now. You're not captain.
So, you guys go into the teleport room, and Maid Joanna activates it and sends you guys on your way. Don't worry, no weird visions this time. Let's say I wrote predominantly to Anushka, but no weird visions this time. You guys teleport to, she notifies Lord Traherne. It's like sending a wire of money, you know? You gotta call, like, both ends call each other, hey, a wire's coming. Hey, a bunch of fucking Avengers are coming through.
Hey, some jackasses said they work for you? Yeah, let them through.
Sending you some people.
So, she notifies Lord Traherne's estate, and then she sends you guys through. Mission accomplished. You guys end up in Duvros towards the evening. Well, at this point, it'd probably be like 8 o'clock. Oh, wait, no, time zones!
Right. By an hour, maybe?
Probably like, I don't know, a couple hours, an hour, something like that. So, we'll say it's 10 o'clock here, 8 o'clock when you get there. With the arrival time, 8 o'clock. There you go.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Let's switch gears, shall we? To Silas. I imagine this one, I think, is going to be relatively quick, but you let me know. It doesn't have to be. So you get that message from Sejar towards the evening time, around like say 5 o'clock or so, 4 o'clock, thereabout.
Okay.
Yeah, so you get that message from Sejar, and then you get the message from Captain Bellamy about like 30 minutes to an hour afterwards. And you're the one that, you know, told everyone, all right, we're meeting Duvros and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. Do you head out that day or do you wait until the next one?
Because
it only takes an hour to get through to get to the forest. Through the forest is like 10 minutes. And then you're hunky dory.
Don't forget the donut.
Don't forget the donut.
Precious donut.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think there'd be any reason they wouldn't. At this point, they'd have everything sorted out with their, you know, family farm and all that. So there's kind of no reason for them to stay, and they're kind of anxious to get back with the group.
Sure.
I'm sure... Mm-hmm. I know it's because Dorky's not here, but do we have any...
I have like, no input from her or anything like that.
What Deed is doing? Okay.
I'm afraid not, no. Well, funny you mention that. So you go to begin like collecting everyone. You get like, you know, Zol, you get Tolis, yeah, you get all of them. But you eventually arrive at Deet. And Deet sort of like just sort of chilling there, you know, and they're just like, hey Deet, and then she just sort of stares out in the distance. And then you like try to shake her, and then she eventually like rouses and like, you know, asks you what's going on. Romeo Arcana.
Okay.
Second, I have my sheet up. Oops. That was the right sheet. That's wrong. Persona.
Right sheet, wrong. Yeah, wrong. That's fine. So 16, as you like put your hand on her to like sort of stir her from her contemplative state, if you want to call it that, you notice that she's giving off latent magic. Like energy. And given her reaction to you just now, it doesn't seem like she's aware of it.
But it's coming from her, not from a separate source that's on her at all?
Correct. Well... Gosh, this is gonna be really hard. Throw me another arcana. That one was for the detection. That one, okay, less so. Yeah, it's hard to tell. There is definitely something in her that's giving off this energy, but you're not sure if it's something that she's causing, right? So the battery is in her. The switch is somewhere else.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And as like you know, she's like you know ready to follow you and do all that stuff, but you notice that she just is. She doesn't have that same alacrity, that sort of fluidness and speed of movement. She's slower. She's more, I want to say calm. That means something like it's good. More, not lethargic, that means something like she's sleeping, but she's slowed, so to speak. She's slowed in physical and mental activity. That's not to say like she's been like struck blind, deaf, and dumb like Helen Keller, by the way. No, she's still a functional person.
Mm-hmm. No, I get what you mean.
But yeah, definitely weird. Definitely weird.
Yeah. I think as long as she seems in a condition to, you know, still move, Silas would just stay near her, but we'd head out that day.
Okay.
Well, evening, I guess.
Yeah, you head out that evening. You give your goodbyes to all the rioters. You give your goodbyes to the outlaws, the outlaw crew. To the outlaw crew, any words to tell to the weird cat of the village that you grew up with?
I think Ajax does have some parting words. I guess when Silas says goodbye, he says, "I hope you find what you're looking for. I'm sorry things worked out this way."
Oh.
I'm just glad things were settled.
I do have one favor to ask of you.
That's a raise an eyebrow.
You're a bard.
Mm-hmm.
You're creative.
Mm-hmm.
How does the Haze Hound sound for a gig?
The Where's the ball? Hounds.
Is that more we're saying that?
That is not more. Is that really? Is that the best shot you got?
Two in the nose.
Is that Silas is doing, I guess, the standing equivalent of what I'm doing, which is leaning and putting a hand on their chin, like, You know what? If you get out of here quickly, maybe you won't die of cringe, like me.
It's a Heartlandic term. It's a slang thing.
I've got a lot going on in my head right now. I'll get back to you on that.
Okay, cool. Try not to die, please. That'd be very inconvenient to find out you did that. So, you know,
you guys too. Don't die.
It happened to me.
It's happened to me before too. I never told you. I have.
Oh, really?
Yeah,
we're in like a special club now.
Whoever just looks between the conversation at Ajax, like, what is happening here?
I forget. How did she die? How did she die again?
Shot or something.
You had firing squad.
I was like firing squad basically.
Yeah, I was pretty funny. Oh,
God. Yeah, it was. Yeah.
Says just kind of holds up the hand and goes, almost.
It's even better because you teleport into their like kill zone too, which is even funnier.
I know, right? What can I say? I'm not one for making wise decisions. Rational decisions are not my forte. You should all be aware of this by now.
Wise made rash decisions.
So I'll just put a hand on shoulder. Yeah, sure. Don't die again, okay? It's not fun.
Do my best. Only if you do, though, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Right, well, good luck, I guess.
If we hear something about the people that took your family, we'll hit you up.
You better.
I don't think we will. Yeah. Oh, sorry, I'm offering help. Never mind.
No.
I'd be afraid for you if you did interact with them, so maybe don't.
If we see them, I'll send a smoke signal.
Oh my god.
Oh god, that's what you're gonna call all communications now, aren't you?
Yeah, okay.
We can't let him be in charge. Uh-huh. He can't be in charge.
Yeah, no, that's gonna be.
Anyway.
So, yeah, don't die.
We get a social media manager. I won't either. Manager.
So you continue to give me your goodbyes. You do arrive at Wolfgang and Nazarena, who, you know, pretty chill. I mean, Nazarena's probably really fucking exhausted from all the PT work, but, you know, Wolfgang is fine.
Wolfgang is Wolfgang,
yeah.
He's got one hand on the palm of his right hand. He's got his feet propped up on her, who's on all fours. So, he's using her
doing push-ups.
So I was like, what in the fuck is this? Huh?
Just called cleaning.
So he never says.
Okay, I don't suppose you'll be coming with us then.
Shakes his head. But give my regards to your teacher. And tell her I'll be in touch.
If I see her, I will. Though I don't know if she'll be there when I get back.
Well, you've gone into her house, so I imagine she'll have some choice words to say to you.
Okay. Yeah, Tolis, like, awkwardly rubs the back of her neck, like, who does that?
Back, she's gonna know.
Look at her and be like, you're staying with me until we have that conversation with her. I'm not doing that alone.
He holds up two plague of hands. Yeah. It's fine, I won't want to know anything, though. It's fine.
Alright.
Don't worry about finding her, she'll find you.
I know.
Well, it's just like, shakily lowers her hands at that, like, oh no.
It's just nodding, like, they've tried this already. They're like, I know.
There is no escape.
Die.
But yeah. You give your goodbyes, and you're sort of wondering where Evelina is, and as you're sort of, like, making your way, because she sort of disappeared. As you're making your way out of town, she's at, like, basically, like, a signpost at the edge of the city limit, if you want to call it that. Like a rock sort of post area. And she's just sort of playing music.
Do I recognize what she's playing?
Performance.
Okay. That I can do. Where is it? Roll, please.
Okay. Not bad.
I don't know if you had guidance, because it's sort of a memory thing, but,
I always keep guidance on anyway, because I will forget otherwise.
Yeah. It's an instance of you trying to remember, so yeah, I'd say you have the guidance. Not that it matters, because you succeeded anyways. She's playing Clair de Lune.
Oh! Mm-hmm.
She heard you play it.
Her now. Someone's a copycat, there can only be one.
You think you'd win against Evelina? Good
no.
fucking joke.
Are yeah, you kidding joke. Me?
So you guys end up like approaching her as she's like sort of just playing Clair de Lune, but she's not playing on like a violin or anything. She's somehow playing it on a guitar, rather weirdly enough. It sounds really different than what you're used to. She does also have some auxiliary instruments being played with magic, or rather the minor illusion sound effects of it, but she's like constantly casting it through her playing. So it does sound like a three-person band right now.
Does she like see us approach?
She does, but she just sort of waits for you guys to close the distance before she even does anything. As you guys do end up doing that, she just sort of stops playing and looks to you. On your way out, then?
That we are.
She tuts like, what a shame. But that's okay.
We've got a lot of stuff to handle, so I can't say I regret leaving.
She nods slowly at that. You have been rather tense lately, so not surprising. So I suppose it's farewell for now.
For now.
I'm sure we'll be seeing each other very soon. I'm sure our paths will cross again. She scans across not just you, but the entire group, the guitar company. And I bet you guys are pretty easy to find.
Getting easier day by day.
If you see Sajar again, do remind him of his oath. And that we are expecting him. Now, at the very least. And I hope he's alright. You nod. Like, yep. Gotcha, boss.
Well, so it seems like in thought, they're just like, yeah, well, he said he'd find us. They didn't say that, but like, that's what's going on in their mind, is they're just like, yeah, well, he said he would, so he'd be fucking better.
True.
He'll get the message.
Good. Now, the rest of you can file on, and Cyrus had, like, one last word with you.
Alright.
You turn around. Deet sidles on. Abigail sidles on. Tola sidles on. Zola's like, I don't know. Maybe I want to stay.
This sounds like get go.
Won't get.
No, I don't think I will. I don't trust her.
You don't.
A gun is cocked for the twins.
You should go.
Oh my god, you're so good.
Oh, how interesting. It's a wisdom save on that one as well, right?
Yeah, well, fucking, where is it?
Oh,
well, I mean.
Honey, here's the funny thing. There's a reason I rolled one before you hit the suggestion spell.
Yeah?
You and Evelina both instruct him to go.
Oh, they're like a power couple made in heaven.
So he succeeds against you, because that's a pretty fucking sweet 18, but the 16 does fail against Evelina. He's just like,
well, I was gonna cutting words it if he did succeed.
Alright, fine. Just don't take too long.
Mm-hmm.
He walks away, he looks over his shoulder. Looks back forward, walks a little bit more, looks over his shoulder.
Oh, I care.
Just walking forward.
Him, like, aww. Keep walking.
He's just like, I got my eye on you.
When he finds out, he gonna be mad.
Mm-hmm. If
they never find out, is a thing.
If he finds out.
Yeah, it was a suggestion. Yeah.
No, if someone tells him, I mean.
Yeah, but no one else is here, so.
That's true.
And I'm not snitching.
So, yeah, he keeps walking. He keeps looking over his shoulder back at you guys, like, recurringly, like, mm. It's like, what's like watching a cat chat, like, try to sneak up on you. But eventually, he's out of earshot. And she, Evelyn just looks at you. Nice use. Cool. I have to ask this. And she gestures with a finger between you and her. Yes? No? Maybe so?
I think yes.
She nods slowly at that, like, okay, she's like processing that. And then she grabs you by like the collar, I guess. That's her area. Brings you in close and gives you a kiss on the cheek. It's a yes then. And then she sort of turns you, like you're facing down the road, and then pats you, like, go on then.
That's it. I have to leave after that?
Distance makes the heart grow fonder.
Alright.
You keep walking, remnant of a kiss on your cheek, then you suddenly feel a pat on your bum and a tug on your tail. From a distance, of course, but not that you can ever confirm that. So, you keep walking, catch up with the rest of your group. Bards do bard things to one another, I suppose. You guys traverse into the damned forest at night, which is, you know, 99% of people who say that, I think only, like, less than 10% of them come back out, so, you know. Hopefully, you know, you guys are amongst that number. You guys traverse into the damned forest. Don't worry, I won't screw you and be like, did you get the donut? You didn't say you got the donut. You guys got a fresh donut.
Around fucking sprints.
Nah. You guys have a fresh donut. If anything, your boy probably made one for you, Reggie.
Oh, yeah.
No fresher than homemade, bitch! Can't trick us on that! But yeah, you guys begin traversing through the damned forest, and then suddenly, at some point, the donut does disappear. And minutes in the dark, well, it's moonlit, but, you know, not exactly the best conditions, pass, and you come out in Leliac. You talk with the guards. They're a bit confused that you came out of the damn forest, but they're also notified ahead of time that you guys would be, so all good. You guys get ushered into or towards the teleportation room, guided over there, and it's good to go. You don't see Maestro Connor. You don't see the commander of the Vinkoshi. You don't even see Marshal Neil.
I was gonna say, do we see Neil?
You do not.
Shame.
If you ask the guards about it, they just tell you that, oh, The weirder fella, he just up and left. The guards out in Narum just said, like, he just suddenly said he had something to do, and then he just sort of walked away, and then he walked out of the place, and then he sort of just disappeared in town, and don't even know what happened to him. Well, you need him for something.
It was more of a curiosity more than anything.
Ah. Well, now you know. But, teleportation's ready. Hope you guys enjoyed your stay in time here in the Heartlands.
Always do. And that is a lie. They did not have a fun time.
Roll deception!
Alright! Where is it? Fuck!
He notes that you lied to him. Well,
and you can probably see the sadness in their eyes.
About to cry at all.
Well, I hope wherever you're going is just as good a stay and better. But let's get you out of here then. Come on, everyone, fire then. And you guys teleport to Lord Traherne's estate in Dubros.
And then we all dogpile on top of each other as everyone teleports at the same time.
No, you all morph into one amalgam.
Oh god. Yeah.
Sorry.
Oh, that's so end of the campaign.
And that's what Chaplain Bellamy's plan this whole time was. Big brain, idiots.
Right, I might jump off if that's okay, this little break, if that is acceptable.
Just because sure, I'm not going to get a level 2
Percy, you should know it's never acceptable.